important note. If any matrix A which is symmetric and or skew symmetric or orthogonal matrix, then A is always normal matrix. I will prove only one property. I will prove that if A is symmetric, then A is normal. Okay, I am repeating. If any matrix A which is symmetric and or skew symmetric or orthogonal matrix, then A is always normal matrix. We know that A square matrix A is called normal matrix if A into A dash bar is equal to A bar dash into A. But when A is real matrix, I am repeating, when A is real matrix means that the entry of the matrix is real. In this case, A is equal to always A bar. Okay, now given that A is symmetric matrix, given that A is symmetric matrix means that A is equal to A transpose, then in for the case of real matrix A is equal to A bar, then the normal matrix can becomes normal matrix can become A into A transpose is equal to A transpose into A, means that A is equal to A bar. Then now given that A is symmetric matrix, means that A is equal to A transpose, putting the value of A. Okay, I am putting the value of A. Value of A is equal to A transpose. Add the value of A transpose is equal to A is equal to value of A transpose is equal to A. Value of A, value of A is equal to A transpose. Means that A transpose into A is equal to A into A transpose. Means that A is normal matrix. Okay, similarly you can prove that the skew symmetric matrix or orthogonal matrix is also normal matrix. Please listen carefully. We know that the symmetric matrix is always real matrix, skew symmetric matrix is always real matrix, and orthogonal matrix is also real matrix, but the normal matrix is not a real matrix, it is a complex matrix. But in the case of skew symmetric and orthogonal, the value of A bar is always A. So that skew symmetric matrix and orthogonal matrix is always normal matrix. Okay, next topic. Determinant. The determinant is a function. Determinant denoted by this notation or mod. Determinant is a function from any square matrix to real number. Means that determinant is a function from the matrix A11, A12 and so on, AN1 and so on, ANN to real number system. Okay, I am repeating. Determinant is nothing but a function from matrix to the set of real number, or the determinant is always a scalar quantity, and we can calculate the determinant of any square matrix. Okay, now I am taking some example of determinant. Means that A is any matrix with order 1 cross 1, then the determinant of A is equal to element, means that 1, so that determinant of A is equal to 1. Again, if A is equal to any matrix which is square matrix and the entry of 1, 2, 3 and 4, then determinant of A can be calculated this into this and this into this with minus sign. Means that 1 into 4 minus 2 into 3. So that determinant of A 4 minus 6 means that determinant of A is equal to minus k 2. Okay. Again, important note. If the determinant of any square matrix is not equal to 0, then the matrix is known as non-singular matrix or invertible matrix. Similarly, if the determinant of any square matrix is equal to 0, then the matrix is known as singular matrix. I am repeating other concept. If the rows or column of any square matrix are linearly dependent or one row is multiple to other row, then the determinant of this square matrix is always zero and the matrix is known as singular matrix. Similarly, if the rows and the column of any square matrix are not multiple to each other, means that any two row or any two column or any three row or any three column are not multiple to other rows or other column, then the matrix is always non-singular matrix and the value of determinant of this matrix is always not is equal to zero. Okay, and the rows or the column of this matrix is always linearly independent from. I will discuss in linear algebra what is the linearly dependency and what is the linearly independency of the set of vectors. Okay, now if A is other square matrix with the entry 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0, 0, 1 and 2. The order of this matrix is 3 cross 3. Now, I am calculating the determinant of A. At first, I will take 1 and deleting row which is the both side of 1 means that I am deleting this row and this column. Remaining part is 5, 0, 1, 2. And the sign of any determinant is always alternate. Means first sign is positive, second sign is negative, third sign is positive, and so on. And what is the reason to taking this sign alternate, I will discuss in next topic or in next lecture. Okay, this is positive. Now minus 2 into delete this column means that 5 1 delete this row, remaining entry is 4 0 and 2 0 0 2. Similarly plus minus plus 3 into deleting this column, this row and this column, this row, this column, remaining entry is this, means that 4, 5, 1, 0 and 1. Now determinant of A is equal to 1 into this 10 minus this into this minus this into this with minus sign. 2 into 5 means 10 minus 0 minus 2 into this minus this into this means that 4 into 2 8 minus 0. Similarly 3 into this 4 minus 0. So that determinant of A is equal to 10 minus 16 plus 12. Okay, means that 22 minus 16 means that determinant of A is equal to 6 or determinant of A is equal to 0. Okay, I am checking linearly dependency or linearly independency. This row is not multiple of this row or not multiple of this row. Similarly, this column is not multiple of this column, or this row is not multiple of this column, is not multiple of this column. Similarly, this column is not multiple of this column, or this column is not multiple of this column, or this column is not multiple of this column. Similarly, we can check row and column. If any row or any column are not multiple to each other, then the value of the determinant is not equal to 0, and the rows or the column, of the matrix is always linearly independent. And if I write this row into the vector form, means that v1 is equal to 1 2 3, v2 is equal to 4 5 0, v3 is equal to 0 1 and 2. If this I write the given matrix into the vector form, this is v1, this is v2, this is v3, and the determinant of this matrix not equal to 0, then the vector v1, v2 and v3 always linearly independent. Okay, now I am checking other example. Suppose that A is equal to 1 2 3 4 2 4 6 6 4 8 12. Determinant of A is equal to 1 into, by deleting this row and this column, 1 into 4 6 8 12 minus 2 into, by deleting this row and this column, means that 2 4 minus 6 and 12 plus 3 into, by deleting this row and this column, remaining is 2 4 4 8. So that determinant of A is equal to 1 into 48 minus 48 minus 2 into 24 minus 24 plus 3 into 16 minus 16, means that determinant of A is equal to, this is 0, this is also 0, this is also 0. Determinant of A is equal to 0, means that the second row is the 2 times of first row, or third row is the 4 times of first row. Similarly, this column is the 2 times of this column, this column is the 2 times of first column, and this column is the 3 times of the first column. Means that the determinant of the matrix is 0. These rows or these columns is always linearly dependent rows or linearly dependent column or linearly dependent vectors. Okay, this method is applicable for only square matrix. If the matrix is not square matrix, we will check the linearly dependency or linearly independency with other method, and I will discuss what is the method to check the linearly dependency and linearly independency in linear algebra. Okay, next. Properties of determinant. Properties of determinant. First property, number 1, determinant A always exists if matrix A is square matrix, means that we can calculate the determinant of any square matrix. If the given matrix is not a square matrix, we cannot calculate the determinant of this given matrix. Property number 2. Determinant of A transpose is always determinant of A. Okay, this is the second property. I am checking. Suppose that A is equal to 1, 2, 3 and 4. The row of this matrix is always linearly independent or not multiple to each other, and the order of this matrix is 2 cross 2. Now determinant of A is equal to 4 into 1 minus 2 into 3, means that determinant of A is equal to 4 minus 6 is equal to minus 2, not is equal to 0. Again, I am taking A transpose. A transpose means that rows change into the column or column change into the row. I am changing row, means that 1, 2, 3, 4. So that now I am calculating the determinant of A transpose is equal to 4 into 1 minus 2 into 3, means that 4 minus 6, means that minus 2. So that determinant of A transpose is always determinant of A. Okay, but this is necessary. The matrix is always a square matrix, otherwise we cannot calculate that determinant, or determinant is not possible. Okay, next property. If A is diagonal matrix, then determinant of A is equal to product of diagonal element. Okay. I am repeating, if A is a diagonal matrix, then the determinant of A is always product of diagonal matrix, and A matrix is known as diagonal matrix if all the entry except main diagonal is always zero. Okay, an example, suppose that A is any matrix of order 1 0 0 0 2 3 0 0 and 4. I want to say that the determinant of A is equal to 1 2 and 4. 1 into 2 into 4 means that determinant of A is equal to 1 into 2 2 into 4. Determinant of A is always 8. Okay. Now, I am checking other method. Determinant of A is equal to 1 into, by deleting this row and this column, remaining 2, 0, 0, 4, minus 0 into, 0 into 0, 0, 0, 4, 0, 0, 0, 4, plus 0 into 0, 0, 2, 0. Now, determinant of A is equal to 1 into this 4 into 2 minus 0 minus 0 into 4 into 0 minus 0 plus 0 into 0 minus 0 means that determinant of A is equal to 4 into 2 8 minus 0 plus 0. Determinant of A is equal to 8. One important question I will discuss in linear algebra. If the given matrix is any diagonal matrix, then eigenvalue of this diagonal matrix is always diagonal entries. I am repeating. Listen carefully. Suppose that A is any diagonal matrix and the question is this: what is the eigenvalue of this diagonal matrix? And the answer of this question is this: the diagonal element of given matrix is always eigenvalue of this given matrix. And I will discuss what is the eigenvalue, what is the eigenvector, what is the diagonalization, what is the geometric multiplicity, algebraic multiplicity in linear algebra. Okay, I will discuss this later. Next property. Determinant of K into determinant of A is equal to K power N into determinant of A, where K is any number and N is order of given matrix A. Means that suppose that K is equal to 2 and A is equal to 1, 3, 2, 4, then at first I will calculate the k into a, means that 2 into a, 1, 3, 2, 4 is equal to k into a is equal to 2, 2 into 3 is 6, 2 into 2 4, 2 into 4 is equal to 8. So that determinant of k into a is equal to 8 into 2, this into this, minus this into this, with minus sign, okay? 8 into 2 minus 6, 8 into 2 minus 6 into 4, so that determinant of k into a is equal to 8 into 2, 16 minus 24, determinant of k into a is equal to minus 8. Now I am checking k to the power n into determinant of a. K, the value of k is 2, and the order of this matrix is 2 cross 2, means that power is 2 into determinant of a, so that determinant of a is equal to 4 minus 4 into 6, determinant of a is equal to minus 2. After putting the value of determinant of a, means that 2 power 2 into determinant of a, means minus 2, is equal to 4 into minus 2 is equal to minus 8. Okay, so that the determinant of k into a is equal to k to the power n into determinant of a. K is any number and n is equal to order of given matrix. Okay, similarly the determinant of a to the power n is equal to determinant of a power n, where n is always any positive integer. Okay, I am repeating, the determinant of a power n is equal to determinant of a complete power n. Okay. Hello friends, my name is Zakir Hussain and the name of my channel is Mathematician Wings. I'm requesting to you, please like my video or subscribe my channel. Okay, I am heartily request from you, please like my videos and subscribe my channel. Okay, bye.